Wir sind hier in einem Filmstudio, wo die ersten Aufnahmen.
We're here in a film studio, where the first pictures of the new 9/11 are being taken. And I would like to take this as a cue to tell you a thing or two about the car.
Zunächst mal.
First of all, the 9/11 is an automotive engineering icon.
Und sicherlich auch deshalb.
One of the reasons for that is because the design has been cautiously yet very consistently refined over many years.
Wir als Designer wollen vor allem das Verhältnis Breite zu Höhe.
What we as designers are striving for above all is to optimize the width to height ratio, with the result that although the new 911's overall width has not increased, the front axle area has become wider, and we've managed to make the roof a bit lower. Especially from the front, the vehicle appears much flatter and lower, and adheres far more to the road. First of all, the new 911 has to be clearly recognizable as a 911, but also as the new 911. The front wing is typically 911, but the silhouette above the wing has become somewhat sleeker, making it even sportier and even more athletic. We've placed these headlights as far outboard as they will go. The windscreen is more convex and also at a slightly more raked angle. The upshot of all this is that the vehicle's on-road stance is even sportier.
In der Seitenansicht ist es natürlich.
Viewed in profile, it is of course a typical 911. The roof line or fly line, as we call it, falling away to the rear, the typical side window design that unmistakably identifies it as a 911. The mirror has been relocated from the mirror triangle to the shoulder, and is now pretty well where it belongs on a sports car.
Im Dach. Fällt zum Beispiel diese, wie wir sie nennen.
The striking feature of the roof area is what we call the precision edge, which, especially towards the back end, pulls the vehicle together in typical Porsche fashion, emphasizing these trademark Porsche shoulders and making it very nicely apparent where the power is applied to the road in this vehicle.
Für mich persönlich ist das Heck eigentlich.
For me personally, the back end is the highlight. Characterized by very narrow taillights that exude high-tech. And that then unmistakably show even at night that this is a Porsche. But we also have a new element in the tail end, and that is this edge, which again visually emphasizes width and plants the vehicle solidly on the road. With this styling, integrating the rear spoiler very elegantly into the overall sculpture. As on the exterior, so too in the interior. We have tried to create a typical 911.
So wird zum Beispiel auch.
For example, this vehicle is brought to life from the left-hand side of the steering wheel too. In the new 911, the instruments are angled slightly more towards the driver, with the rev counter in the middle, which is here where it belongs in a sports car. This enhances the cockpit impression. A new element, the upward incline center console, already familiar from the Panamera and Cayenne, is found here in this vehicle as well. And it has precisely the effect of making you feel you are seated lower within the vehicle, enhancing the sensation of connection with the vehicle yet further.